Hello everybody, this is Rupali Malik of Chessbase India reporting from Veliko Gradiste, the Silver Lake Open. We have here with us Grandmasters Ronak Sadwani and Nihal Sareen. Ronak, what went through your mind when you realized that there are only two people now at 4 points and you have to play Nihal tomorrow?
Yeah, okay, I just tried to play normally. Okay, since I was white, I just wanted to get a game and play, which I think I got, but then I misplayed, I think, at one point. But okay, that's all right.
Okay, but were you excited to be paired against Nihal?
Yeah, okay, I expected, yeah, we would get at least one game here.
Correct. And how many times have you played him in the past?
I think once we played in Gibraltar. And we played, I think, some online. Okay, we have played a lot, yeah. So over the board only once.
Only once before this?
Yeah. We played in some old nationals.
And very old
nationals. Ah, yeah. What was it? Under 9? What? 11?
No idea. 11 maybe. Maybe 11.
Yeah.
So, Nihal, how was your game today according to you?
It was very decent. And I don't know. It was very complicated and I was out of the opening pretty early and I just tried to think a little bit and make some logical moves.
You didn't think a little bit, you thought a lot, because I have a video that proves that. Did you find yourself out of opening preparation in this game?
Yes, I did, and I just wanted to not get busted straight out of the opening, so thought it's worth taking some time at the start and just to...
Yeah, okay, I was out of the preparation when he played f5. I had knight d2, queen d2 in my preparation. So it was Rosolimo. Knight f3, knight c6,
yeah.
Bishop b5, g6, castle, bishop g7, c3, knight f6, rook e1, castle, d4, cd4, cd4, d5, e5, and knight e4, bishop e3, queen b6, bishop c6, queen c6, knight fd2, and this was the moment. Yeah, here I had knight into d2 in my file, queen into d2, and I thought white has quite something, like practically I got 40 minute lead and also maybe 0.2, 0.3, that's perfectly playable.
Yeah.
But f5 I didn't know, so after f5 I was also out of my book.
Yeah, okay. So after knight fd2, like till then I was just making logical moves and just trying to not do something careless. And after knight fd2, which I underestimated at first, then I realized that it can actually get quite unpleasant if I just take d2, queen d2, and then white will just put the other knight on c3, and the bishop on g7 is not so good, and some h4 might come. It's probably okay for black if black just sits with bishop e6, queen d7 and double on the c5, but again, I just wanted to try something a bit creative and more active. So that's how I came up with f5. I was not sure how it was, but it seemed interesting.
So Ronak, what did you think of when you played f5?
No, I tried to make a logic, like I didn't have f5 in my file, so if f5 was played, if any other move, I don't see any advantage, so I just took e f6 out of that logic. I could play g3, but then f4, bishop f4, knight f2, king f2, g5 would be very dangerous.
Okay. Yeah, I saw a similar line. Also after g3, apart from what Ronak mentioned, g5 might also be interesting. Like just preparing f4, and also the queen can swing over to g6 from c6 sometimes.
Okay, I took e f6, he took e takes f6. Then I took knight e4, which I think I have to.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, okay. No other move, I think. d4. Here I could maybe start with knight c3. But okay.
Then I just go f5, d5, queen c4. And somewhat similar to what is in the game. And
yeah, it's playable, I think.
Yeah, like very, in a practical game, I think it's anyone's game.
Yeah. So okay, I played d5 directly, queen c4. Maybe I should have played with knight c3. Instead of knight a3, because the knight got a bit sidelined there, it was not doing much.
Yeah, but it was very hard to understand.
Yeah.
I was just hoping that after queen d3, I'm at least not worse, and maybe I can take over. Like two bishops is always a great asset to have.
Okay. Yeah, so I played knight a3, then queen d3, takes, Okay, I don't know. This position already, I think black should be equalizing. I don't see anything for white here.
And the game continued with knight b5. And it's very complicated, and I thought I had to choose between bishop d7 and bishop f5, and I just chose bishop f5 because it's a bit more general, and also it's some kind of a prophylaxis against rook d1 because pawn is already protected.
So yeah, bishop f5, okay, I played bishop f4 and offered a draw because, okay, I didn't see anything for white at least. And okay, I don't know, maybe black could play on, but okay, I don't know. It's risky even for black at one point if he overextends.
Like here I actually really wanted to, I was really thinking of continuing the game with rook fd8 and followed by some g5 bishop g6, which I really, maybe I should have done that, but again there are, it's not risk free for black, and white always has some ideas like some knight c7, knight e6 or knight d4, and the position is just very complex and it's not easy for both colors with less time, so thought it was a good time to call it a day.
So why don't you tell us what happened through the pandemic and how you kept yourself motivated?
Yeah, you can start.
Yeah, so it was pretty tough time without OTB tournaments, but I had been playing online for a long time and it was not a big issue, and yeah, just there were good online tournaments coming up quite often, and
yes.
So that did keep me quite busy, and yeah, just playing, basically playing online, also trying out some other stuff.
What about you, Ronald?
Okay, I was just playing and watching web series. I had nothing else to do. Like, yeah.
But,
I was bored at one point.
You were bored at home?
Yeah.
Did you ever feel like chess is boring without playing tournaments?
No, I didn't feel like that. I was just playing online and okay, watching some web series or going somewhere out. Yeah, so. Yeah.
Okay, but were you training hard?
Yeah, when I was training, I was training. Yeah. When I didn't feel like, I didn't. Yeah,
it was not easy, but again, I did not have much trouble to get used to it because I was
already playing so much.
Yeah, I was already. I think Ronak was also playing quite a lot.
Yeah, I think
so,
in lockdown,
yeah.
I have increased a lot of strength in bullet.
Yeah, even
much
before
more.
You were playing quite a bit, I think.
Yeah, I was playing,
yeah.
But not this much. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And so, Ronak, we also know that you tried your hand at having your own YouTube channel, and
yes.
You were doing some YouTube videos. How was that for you?
Okay, at one point it was interesting, but then it got boring, so I just said, okay, let's just play.
Yeah, in the middle it had picked up a lot, right? Everybody
yeah.
is sitting and playing games and bullet chess and... So
yeah, at times I played like 6 hours on straight, yeah, 30-second games.
Online?
And then go mad, yeah.
Oh, interesting, very fun. And did you try anything like that, Nihal? YouTube channel, streaming live?
A little bit, but again, like when I stream, I play much worse.
Oh, you do stream? I did not know that, Nihal.
I mean,
okay.
A little bit. Like, I do stream some. Sometimes I stream some title arenas and stuff, but I play really badly.
Yeah,
and
quality goes down heavily if you stream and play.
Because you're bantering, right?
Yeah.
So, banter mix,
yeah.
Is that what it's called? Have
yeah.
you tried that?
Yeah.
Doesn't work.
It's not so easy. Like,
it's not so. And that's why you have so much respect, no, then for Nakamura and Magnus, and they're bantering
yeah.
and they're playing like brilliant chess. It's something to, you know, look up to.
Yeah,
I think Nakamura is just the king. Yeah, with streaming, we can beat anybody even.
And he's so funny. I mean, he has a great sense of humor and, you know, he plays great chess. So, it's just amazing to watch him. But this is good. I'm, you know, very happy to see both of you play here. I really wish both of you all the best. And do well. We want position 1 and 2. Is that enough pressure or do you want more?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best for the rest of the rounds.
Thank you.
Thank
Bye.
You. Thank
Bye.
You.